Hello and welcome to the Gear for Music studio. I'm Laurie. Today we're looking at the TD-50 and what better drummer to demonstrate it than Mr. Craig Blundell.
Hey Laurie. How's hey everybody.
Going? Craig, what can you tell us about the TD-50KV?
There's so many new features here, obviously with this amazing TD-50 brain with its new prismatic sound engine, the addition of digital pads. There's so much we can talk about, but I think we should just slim it down and show the guys some simple bullet points and how they can get the best out of it and really tailor that this amazing kit to themselves.
Yeah.
The main bullet points realistically for me is we have a brand new sound engine, prismatic sound engine, and we have digital pads. So we have digital ride, a digital snare, which feature electrostatic triggering technology, which if I'm more than happy to show you actually. So let's think about this. We've got, if we're looking at modern technology, like everyone has a smartphone nowadays, mm-hmm. don't we? The digital age that we're in. And you know, if you're accessing the smartphone and getting it to work with a pair of gloves on, it's quite difficult. It's kind of like the same here. So essentially it works off the static in your hands. For example, here, if I'm playing the ride cymbal, just like pretty much all our range, you can choke a cymbal. That's taken as read. Mm-hmm. People take that as read nowadays, don't they? The first thing I'll notice as a player, as a drummer, it's probably that placebo effect, but I'm playing a bigger cymbal. So I want to kind of really lean into it. It can handle the sound, which is fantastic, mm-hmm. but you can completely control the sound. Now, the sounds we put on the cymbals are based and actually real samples of cymbals we've sourced from all over the world. So if you want that real beautiful Istanbul, Zildjian, Meinl, Paiste, Sabian, whatever, you can have it. That's the beauty. But it behaves just like the cymbal. So it's extremely expressive. Yep. And the digital technology allows me not just to hold on to a cymbal and stop it, I can control it.
Yeah.
I can absolutely control it. And instead of just being the sound that I'm going to mute on or off, I can different levels of muting from the bell down. I can put my hand over it. I can just put a finger and gradually mute it. It's really expressive. And this is great when you're recording, obviously. And you've got complete
really
control. With the snare drum, it's exactly the same. Now, I've seen over the years, and I've been playing electronic drums since like, well, probably before you were born, actually.
Yeah.
But I've been playing electronic drums for many, many years, with my inspiration being Bill Bruford back in the day with his old Simmons kits and stuff, you know?
The Hex ones.
Literally hit a pad and hope it would trigger something, you know, big one-shots. Yeah. Now we've got this amazing big 14-inch snare drum. Once again, it's like the placebo effect where you're playing a bigger pad. You can dig into it. It feels better. Mm-hmm. Has a three-ply mesh head as well, so it triggering-wise, you can really detune the head. It behaves how I want a head. Everyone talks about real heads, whatever that may be. Everything's a real head, isn't it? So it's how you want that to behave. Now, we were talking about before we started shooting this video, you see people when they're playing rim shots. I've seen people playing their rim shots like this to try and get a consistent rim shot. This is a beauty. Now because I'm going to play the rim shot here, or cross stick, as it were. Mm-hmm. I can't get a cross stick sound off the snare drum.
No.
Because it's not recognizing that my hand is anywhere near the snare drum, because naturally drummers will play a cross stick with their left hand at the bass here.
Yep.
So what's happening here is the electrostatic sensor knows that my hand is on the snare drum and it changes the sound from two. And just to prove it, I'll show you here. So I'm going to play the same thing.
Yep.
And all I'm going to do is wave my hand down. I'm not actually going to touch the skin. I'm just going to put it above. I'm not going to change the velocity of the stick so you can see you get the perfect cross stick. Here we go. It's kind of like the David Blaine moment, isn't it? But it's kind of cool.
There's a tiny bit of distance there that's sensing the amount. Just like an acoustic drum head would respond. It's the physics of the air. It's actually there.
And that's quite nice. So exactly. So if I'm going from there, playing a snare drum beat like this, when I change to my cross stick, I can do it with ease. Can't do it like that.
Yeah.
And that's brilliant.
This is arguably the best drum head around now for electric kits.
Yeah.
When you were playing just then with the ghost notes, how important is it to have this sensing when going to the cross stick, you know, if you're doing some styles where you're coming off ghost notes here, but then having that sensing lightning fast you know, triggering to make sure that it works like a snare drum would, like an acoustic snare.
Yeah.
So
I mean, I'm
just
still,
what you were doing there. That's just what I was. That thank came you. To I mean, my
I'm
mind.
I'm still a traditionalist. I love my acoustic instruments, and I love my electronic instruments. And there's always been that: are you an acoustic drummer? Are you an electronic drummer? And never the twain shall meet. You know, we live in a digital age. You know, technology is evolving. You look at everyone's phones. It used to be a house brick, and now everything is smaller and more effective and faster and quicker. I've always fused both drums together, and it's fantastic. You can have these amazing instruments, but why not fuse together some electronics? Do the hybrid thing, as the cool word is for that. Now, with this, and certainly it's evolved so much now. My snare drum practice, I can practice on home on a 14x6 snare drum, or I can practice here on my 50.
Yeah,
detune it up. There's more sensors in the pad than ever before as well. Not that the bigger is better, but exactly where I'm playing on the drum. Yeah. Anywhere I play around this drum. Every single note is going to be heard. So it's not a false economy of practice. The beautiful thing about this is more advanced than it's ever been. Every single note you're going to play from a ghost note, as you're saying, quiet ghost notes, you're not going to lose any. As many as you can throw at it, it'll play.
I just noticed there, when you switch, for a player like you, switching between single stroke rolls and doubles is seamless. It's smooth, it's consistent, it's velocity there. But for someone who's not there, you can really tell when you're playing a single stroke, whether as opposed to a double stroke, and that's really picked up in this new snare.
Absolutely.
So if you could like show some budit kind of how not to do a double stroke roll.
Interesting.
And how would you blend it into a smooth single stroke roll?
Yeah, I mean, I was always taught,
because this is the most, this pad will really show us.
It will show it. Yeah, I mean,
it'll show everything
because it's lightning fast. You can't hide. Yeah. Whereas, on back in the day, I take it to be like an old fogey, but back in the day, you used to be able to play stuff and it wouldn't always trigger every single note. Now, it will trigger absolutely everything. The way I was taught by one of my teachers is if you're in the room with somebody and you're playing a certain rudiment, they wouldn't know how you're sticking it. You know, and that's the thing, you know, if someone's playing singles and switches to doubles, I want them exactly to be the same as our single. So most of my practice now, and the beauty about electronic kits now is that you can play till silly o'clock in the morning and you're not going to upset your neighbours. That's the great thing about it. So I can practice longer, and it's a genuinely realistic, great practice tool, because I can slacken my head off, I can work the wrist, or I can tighten my head up and feel like I'm on a military snare drum.
Yeah.
And the brain, every single time, will read every single note I'm going to throw at it.
You can really get some detailed practice in, I think you'll agree. So yeah, touching on creativity and recording there, let's talk about some of the new sounds and kit presets on the TD-50.
Yeah.
I'm well aware that, you know, by now everyone's aware you can put your own sounds on this. But let's talk more about the advantages of doing this that you would get as being a drummer.
Okay. Okay, so realistically, there's 50 patches on there. And with this module, they're very strong patches with some really deep samples. The emphasis here, certainly for me as a musician, is to dig that little bit deeper. And it's given you a tool to do that pretty much, really. So yes, you can put your own sounds on there, which already, as an end user, if you're quite intelligent and thinking about what can I put on there? Because people just go for snare, kick, et cetera, et cetera. You can do anything. So, and all I'm doing is I'm taking my little SD card, I'm scouring the internet or going to my little studio, always on the hunt for sounds. If you've got a little field recorder or a microphone, you can literally anywhere you want. I'm obsessive with this.
Yeah.
Anywhere you walk, I've got a little recorder with me, and I'll hear a noise and think, oh, that's nice. That's nice. I could have that. I can actually play that on my TD-50 now, which is like, it's ridiculous. That's the cool thing. You could wake up in the morning, hear some pigeons going off and think, right, I'm having that, and record them. And you can have phrases, not just necessarily. Everyone thinks that it's going to be a one shot. No, not at all. You can have our phrases.
Kind
you
of
know,
a full loop on there.
Absolutely. And because the sound engine is so powerful and so fast, you can trigger it in absolute lightning speed. So you're not hitting your own sample, waiting for it to process the sample, and then hearing out your speaker.
No latency.
So there's no real-time latency. Yeah. You're hitting the sound, just like the presets in previous modules, which are lightning fast, and off your own sound, it's reading it the same volume.
Cool. So, Craig, the SD card's inserted. You've collected all kinds of sounds. Now there's thousands of sounds.
Yeah.
As a basic demonstration, clinical point of view, could you give us some advantages of using samples on a kit?
Absolutely.
And play?
Actually, quite a lot of people have actually already asked that. Is that, you know, I've got 50 presets. Why do I need more sounds? Well, you know, you might be faced with that function. Let's say a lot of the guys are function bands, want to sound like the original. They want to play a Motown song, and one of the you know, you're not finding the snare drum you want. You can find the snare drum you want and put it on there. Let's say, for example, you want to play a phrase. You can do. It's increasingly important for drummers now. A lot of drummers are MDs, you know. A lot of drummers get asked to sound like the record. Yeah. And, you know, the record may be the most obscure thing ever, whereas the module, we're not going to have every single sound for every genre of music.
It's impossible.
So with the ability to upload your own sounds, you can be really creative, and you can then say to your future employer or whoever it may be, say, right, okay, I've got, send me the set list. And it's that familiarity. When you're playing a gig, people, you know, punters, as it were, go to these events, they kind of grasp onto what's that sound.
Like, it's not that classic snare sound.
Right,
I remember for that tune. Because
you can play Levy Breaks. You can play it on a little Hello Kitty kit. It's Levy Breaks, but it's not that association. You can play Levy Breaks on this. It doesn't look like a big old Ludwig kit, but it sounds, you guarantee, as soon as you start playing, it's like, oh, hello, there's Levy Breaks.
Heads will turn. As people who are looking that way, look that way, because I can hear it.
And it's so simple. Yeah. All I'm going to do is I'll find my sound source. Yeah. I'll plug in my card to my computer. And then I'll drag it onto the import section, put my SD card, and then I will load it onto the module. I'll show you how quick it is, as we've already referenced how quick it reads it. All I've done here, and it's quite silly, but it works really, really well, is I've recorded my voice.
Nice.
So I've taken my voice, talking through all the elements of the kit. Yes. Now, there's a couple of things here. People have been saying, I've read various forums, etc. I shouldn't, but I do. I have a look at various forums. You can only do one sample at one time. Nonsense. Okay, I'm going to prove that theory as well. So, for example, we've got the kick.
Kick, 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 kick.
Snare.
Snare, 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 snare.
And it's not just every single, like, pad. It's every single zone.
Rim, one. Rim, ride. Bell, crash. Floor. Rim, hat. Rim.
There we go. So,
how many triggers is that then?
Oh, I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, as many as you want
as
it
many
to be.
As
so every single zone can
nice.
Be a
this
different
This is a good, really good place to start as just samples. These are all. This is Craig's voice on a drum kit.
So simple. Yeah. And that's that thing. Everyone's like, okay, so one's going to cancel out the other. Well,
snare, ride. Snare.
There's that theory
Brilliant.
Put to bed straight away. Even threes.
Rim.
So any sound you want, you can do it. And then thinking about that, one of the more powerful elements of the module, and I'm sure there's lots of demonstrations online, but it'd be nice for me to show the guys, is that you're not just thinking, right, it's one sound source. Because you might get that one sample, put it into your module, and it'd be quite thin. Well, what can I do with that? You can do so many things with it, you know. You can say, right, okay, I'm going to take that sound, and then I'm going to layer it with a sample or a sound out of the module. So we're getting two sound sources. So, for example, if I go to my next patch here, which is voice layer, what I've got is my original kick voice that I said, layered with a kick.
Kick.
So let's say, for example, I've got the original sounding sample, and then I have got my sound at the module. I can have them 50% like that. There's different layers I can put them in. I can put them as fades. So it could be velocity. So if I'm hitting harder, the sample will come in, or the preset will come in. I can have them like that, and I can move them anywhere I want. So I could have slightly more voice, slightly less kick. I can also, what Roland introduced on the TM2, which I think was really groundbreaking, was having what we call elements. So how that drum will behave in a certain environment, whether it be like a brass overtone or an attack. So I could have my voice, and then I could have the attack of a big 26-inch kick underneath it. Just a click, just a click. So now I've got my, going back to my previous patch, my voice here.
Snare.
Layered with another snare.
Snare.
And that's 50%, so that's right in the middle. So now I've got a little bit more punch and attack to it.
Kick, rim, kick, rim, kick, rim, kick, rim, kick, one, rim, floor, kick.
So layering, I mean, you're getting into a whole world of creativity now. So I've got one of my preset samples that I found, and then layering it with some of the stuff that's actually already in the 50 sound engine. Really powerful. So I can have an absolute wall of sound. Yeah. If for the purist, you can take it one step further. If you are hybrid and you do have triggers, let's think about this. I've got my kit. I've got my kick and my snare, acoustic.
Yep.
I've inserted a trigger onto the snare drum with the TD-50 module. So on top of my acoustic snare, I might find a sample that I like on top of the acoustic snare. So that's two sound sources. On top of that, I might find the element I like. So three sound sources now. So you've got a huge wall of sound. So I've got my acoustic snare drum, which I absolutely love, layered with a sample, which is also layered with an element. So essentially, three sound sources coming out the front. It's ridiculous. And then I could go and record that. You know, I can go and play that live. So any one of these elements I have on the kit, I can be creative with. I mean, it's a minefield.
Yeah.
It's an absolute minefield because I find myself getting, really excited about it. You get up in the morning and I find myself recording some presets and thinking, oh, that'd be quite nice. A little Radio King would be great on that song. Yeah. Brilliant. There you go. Layered, done. So I've got, maybe let's say for an example, a straightforward 14x5 acoustic snare drum, layered with a Radio King, layered with overtones of a brass snare drum. Endless creativity.
That's crazy. In a studio, this is the forefront of drumming. So 20 years on from 1997, 2017, we've got three possible layers for one drummer to play in real time.
If you're playing hybrid, absolutely. Yeah, of course.
You've got the fastest, not the fastest, but some of the fastest military chops around, right? Let's see how fast it is. Right, I want you to do some buzz rolls between the toms while doing a double kick on the feet.
Okay.
And then some of the hi-hat as well. Let's really, really push it.
It is fast. It's lightning fast.
Some of this prog stuff you do is incredible, and I just want to see you do
the most important thing about that. I mean, I taking nothing away from the pop drummers that will play this instrument, which is amazing.
Yeah.
I play progressive music, so I'm introducing this into my setup. You know, on the next tour I'm doing, I will have this in my setup. Not probably this setup. I'll probably have my acoustic. I'll probably have a couple of these snare drums. I'll probably have your triggers, you know. There's no head, you know, you can do anything you want. Because it plays it so fast. If I'm just playing double stroke. It's lightning fast.
That is fast. Could you combine it with the sample sounds?
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. So that is my original sample sound.
Just what you're talking about.
Voice layer. So,
did you hear that ride there? That,
right.
Like, don't you can't argue with that. You cannot argue with. There's no latency there, and you've got full control. You've got a Roland sound, a Cosm, you know, a composite object, sound modeled snare drum sound combined with your own sample.
Yeah.
And now it's finally possible.
All I will say on that, it is finally possible. It's probably not the right thing to say, but get away from the presets.
Yeah.
You know, the presets are great. The presets are fantastic. But it's not until you delve into the realms of possibility you can then come up with some incredible, incredible stuff. There's guys that will get the TD-50 and stay on the presets.
Yeah.
You're not exploring what this is actually designed to do. It's designed to make you think outside the box a little bit. So find samples, find things you can put on it, and then start layering. Mm-hmm. Start really... You know, we're talking about the mixer and the EQ here is unbelievable, you know. So you find the snare drum, you think, oh, you know what, that just sits really middly in my mix. Change it. You can, you know, the editing tools here. Mm-hmm. In fact, the editing tools in general are so much more powerful, you know. It's just like battleships. You got four across, four down, and then any one of those squares, you think, oh, I like that sound, but, okay, don't just log off and go away from it. Stay on that sound and explore the EQ parameters, the transients, the room mic, the modeling, anything you want to do to make that. And this is before you put a sample on there. You know, it's absolutely endless.
And once you do put samples on there, You're saying you could empty the contents of whatever you've got on your iPhone and make it into a drum kit and make it into all the crazy time signatures that come with oddly length WAV files.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that's drum along to it.
Yeah, totally.
So how's that for the future?
It is. And people, people rightly or wrongly assume that if you are going to put sampling onto a drum set, it's just going to be one-shot samples. Yeah. Yes, it is, but it could be a phrase. I mean, I'll just show you here. You can do loops. So I can not just take a snare sound, I can record my voice and assign it to any one of these instruments. So I've got... So I can control that. So that could be the start of a backing band, you know. Yeah. It could be the start of a piece of music. I can run them continuously. I can add to them. So if I want to put two... Yeah. And then you can build up on your sound. So if I've got a loop here... I've layered, I put my boom of my voice layered with a kick. So you can then build up. This is where the creativity comes into it. I can put a bass line.
So that's your voice. This is just things that you've created. Yeah. And everything is just like an on and off switch for a sample. It's kind of like an SPDSX built into a kit.
Version, yeah. Yeah. It's
the same like quick lightning fact like we've seen Michael Schack do. And of course, you used the demo a lot when the SPDS is out and the SPDSX is out. And it's now just incorporated into a module as standard.
Very much so.
That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, it's interesting. As I change and get a bit more, I don't play all the drum and bass stuff anymore. I'm too old for all that sort of stuff. But, everything changes. But you can still have it. I could still say, right, I listened to this bass loop online last night. I loved it. Hang about, I can play it on my kit quite easily. Yeah, exactly. And you can put them anywhere.
Yeah.
There you go. So already that's inspiring me that I want to play something
drum and bass.
Yeah, exactly.
You're not too old for drum and bass, Craig.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Go on.
But then you can say, right, okay, with any one of these instruments or any one of these samples, I can change to any zone I want. So all this is just snare drums. So you can just go on and on and on and on.
Nice.
And these are just all short samples. See? But also, it's not just going to play one and stop. You can choose in the module to have them loop and loop and loop and loop.
Man, that takes me back to your Dr. Octopus days.
Yeah, all those back in the day.
No, but that drum and bass is pioneering. You know, it's these electronic music. Yeah. It's got electronic drum sounds, an electronic drum kit. You just demonstrated you can play it live.
That's a really good point. It's a really, really good point is that, if we look about electronic drums and we're looking at certainly about TD-50 now, it's so advanced, people will still stereotype that to have one of these and it looks futuristic, whatever that means. They immediately assume, rightly or wrongly, that you're going to play dance, you're going to play trance, hip-hop, drum and bass. No, because I could just now, I can go onto the internet, I can find a bebop kit here that I can feather the beater and bury the beater. I can find some big band loops and I can play along with my favorite big band tunes. You know, it's not, and that's what I do. It's not just like, I'm going to play some it's not about that. You know, whatever you do, whatever style of music you play with sampling, with layering, with this technology, you can play anything at all.
Let's talk about recording of the TD-50.
Yep.
Let's talk about what's new and what the advantages are and what I can achieve with this, well, the best module out there.
Okay, well, if we're looking at previous modules down the range, which a lot of the guys probably at home watching this now have, which is brilliant, there's a couple of ways we can record. We can take direct output, so that'll give you your stereo mix out to your door with your Mac or PC, etc. Now, that's fine if you want to get basic playing out there, which is great. Mm-hmm. The only way you can control it from the off, because it's a stereo mix, is via the analog mixer on the front of your module, on the 30 or on the 20 or on the 50 now, the digital mixer, and save a preset. Now, with 30, we had direct outputs, so we could take our separate kick, our snare, Tom's, Crash's channel, assign them wherever you want. Once again, you can do it here, or you can then do it in your door. The beauty about this now is I can just plug in a USB lead into my, as I've been doing recently, plugging it into my Mac, And now just down one lead. And firstly, it's less cables. Obviously, you've got 10 cables or whatever. You've got cables everywhere. One cable, run it straight into your computer, and then it'll pull out your separate channels, which is just fantastic. Yes. Now, I've been recording quite a lot of things with this recently, and you can take the presets, and we haven't spoke about your own setups yet, which I'm sure we're going to come to, or I can just literally record the MIDI notes. So once again, your neighbors are asleep. If someone's asleep upstairs, you can literally go into your little your room, your studio, wherever you may be, plug it in, one lead straight into your computer, and record a whole session, zip it up, and send it across the world. So you can record an album by breakfast. It's that simple. And sound-wise, you can have any sound you want. If you can hear it, you can create it. And that's the beauty about recording at home with something that is endless headroom for creativity.
That's awesome, Craig. We've touched on a lot of stuff there. We've really gone. We've covered recording. We've covered quite in depth there. And now we've done all the sampling, and we can see where we're at. Mm. Let's just take it back a bit. Let's talk about straight out of the box the TD-50 itself. Yep. What's changed? Where are things? You know, practical things, headphone outputs. Mm. You know, and mainly, let's just talk about the presets.
Yeah.
As soon as I turn it on, what can I hear?
What are you going to get? Right. As we've covered before, you get 50 presets. Headphones. We got bottom left. Two different size headphone cables now, so you can split the output, which is great, and mix in exactly the same, two different.
So that's on the front this time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because it's easier to get your device plugged into the module, basically. And you listen to that.
Most drummers have basically a sea of stuff or a table or loads of stuff here anyway, so you can plug straight into your mix in and practice along. A couple of things that I've noticed which are really simple, which are really, really cool. Set list. For example, here, at the top right of the module, I can press set list. And I can have my whole set in order for any different band. So it's going to give me an infinite amount of set lists. So I can just basically, instead of me going from kit one, I know the next song on my track is 27. So instead of doing that, it's just like an old kit chain, you know, puts everything into a set list. And stupid, but I can change color.
That's
you know, that's
insane.
The thing. So if you get think, oh, have I changed it? In my head, I've cut red, white, blue, red, white, blue, red, white, blue. And that's how they go. Set list is pretty cool. Now, the editing side of things, I don't think it'd be relevant for the guys watching at home for me to go into massive editing stuff. Yeah. You know, you can see what's going on. But if I just press exit, and I'm going to go into my instrument, I can hit my snare drum. Now you can see across the top, I've got instrument, basic, basic two, and advanced. Okay, so using my F keys across the top here, I can access those four parts. Editing is much more advanced. You know, from the snare wires, to the size of the snare wires, to the volume of the snare wires, to ambient mics, it's ridiculous. I can also hear, I have two additions here on the right-hand side of the module, which is page up and page down. So if I go to, let's say, for example, I go to basic one, which is the tuning, the muffling, and the overtone of the snare drum. I can then go down one, and it'll change the mic position. I can also, the top page changes, so I've got the element, so the overhead, the room mic, and the width, so the mic width. So I can change the mic width. If I'm going down one more time, I can then change the transient. Now, the transient's really powerful because this is the time, the attack, and the release of the instrument. So if someone says, oh, it sounds compressed, change the attack. You know, if you're not happy with that, go to mixer, change the actual EQ. If you see it flat, change it. Have the tops pop out the mix, you know? And finally, the final one that we've already covered about layering. Yep. If I press down one more time, that gets me to my layering screen. So I can see here, I've got a Jaraply bass drum. I can then layer that with a sample. I can layer it with a cowbell. I can layer it with anything I want out of the module or off my SD card. So it's essentially battleships, four across, four down. you can do that sort of stuff. At any point, if you're in too deep and people get quite intimidated by technology, just press exit, and you're
panic
only ever
button.
Four clicks away from factory reset. I can then also, once again, now the mixer operates in the same way. If I press mixer, I've got my four F keys across the top, and now the wonderful thing about mixer here, I've got control over the snare and the second zone, or even third zone. So you can see, if I hit the ride cymbal, on the screen, it's just lit up the ride cymbal. I've got the bow, the bell, and the edge. So if my bell isn't quite cutting, I can pop it up volume-wise.
Yeah.
I can then adjust the EQ if I wanted
That's
to
so
as well,
detailed.
Which is really powerful. I press down one more time, and then I've got the pad EQ. So I've got all the bottom end, the mids, and they're used on the R key. So it's just literally, I can put, and you can see it on the screen, I can adjust that EQ. So that's the EQ. Also, on the basic editing, I can adjust the ping volume of the ride
cymbal.
Really?
So that's the attack of the very tip of your stick and how it connects with whatever metal cymbal off.
And if I found my cymbal, so let's say, for example, I'm playing a hi-hat, and I'll show you very quickly on the screen. If I've got a hi-hat, I'll go up to my very first page. I'll go to the instrument, hi-hat. On the R keys here, I've got the instrument. I've got the size of the hi-hat, which we've had in previous models. I can change the sound, obviously. But I've also got the thickness of the hat. So I think, oh, I really like that hi-hat sound. Mm-hmm. I just wish it wasn't so clunky. I can change the thickness. So complete tailorization of I don't know if that's a word, yeah. But you can tailor every single instrument perfectly. But once again, for me, emphasis-wise, is don't get too bogged down with the presets, you know.
Yeah.
I've done hardly anything there. I've just pressed instrument, and then that's where that creative element can come in. Mm-hmm. You can go to mixer, you can go to ambience, you can change the EQ, you can adjust the ping noise of your ride cymbal, you can EQ that, so it's absolutely perfect. Nice. Save it, put it in your set list. So when you hear, when someone goes, I don't like it, I always get really frustrated.
Yeah,
I think,
well,
like,
hang on, we'll change
there's
something.
Hundreds of thousands of things I can do to make you not like that, to make you like it. and it's having that time and that inclination to say, and this is before we put a sample on there, to say, right, okay, why don't you like it? What are we going to do to change it? Because guarantee here you absolutely can.
The modeling is that advanced now.
Yeah. And this is just presets.
Yeah. Craig, that was a fantastic demonstration. Why should I buy this kit over any other kit?
Well, everyone's different. I'm sure, you know, people walk into this amazing place and they'll have a preconceived idea. I want to go a certain manufacturer, and that's brilliant, and that's absolutely fine. You know, there's some amazing, you know, there's some amazing drum sets on the market right now. All I will say, in 40 years of playing, for me personally, taking nothing away from my acoustic drums, which I love so much, I hoard, I collect, and I play my acoustic drums and my cymbals. I'm an absolute freak. When it comes to electronics, you know, there are so many options, but this is the first instrument in all my years of playing which provides me with endless creativity and unlimited possibility. And that's not the corporate answer. That's what I'm finding, that I can just play any sound I want. If I can imagine it, I can layer it, I can play it. And I've never had that before. And that, for me, is the difference. And it's made me smile like nothing else, basically.
Too,
so it's just the next level of technology.
Craig, we could talk about this kit all day. Thanks for coming to the Gear for Music studio and talking to us about the TD-50. For more information, visit the Gear for Music website. I'm Laurie from Gear for Music. Craig Blundell, thanks for watching.